Good morning, good afternoon, good evening, good night. Welcome to wherever you are watching us from in the world, but especially welcome to those viewers who are tuned in now on BBC Sport to see us here from the Telford International Centre for the Wftda European Continental Cup in 2018, the first of its kind in Europe.
Inaugural,
indeed. So my name is Fenn, I'm going to be one of the announcers. Alongside me is Holly.
Hello.
And we have River Rain here throwing stats and keeping track of all the penalties and scores for us silently, just so we know what we're talking about. We're going to be going in soon first with the bronze medal game here, which is, let's just display what we're playing for here, for this lovely bronze medal. So we're going to be seeing Tiger Bay Brawlers skating out of Cardiff in Wales against Dock City Rollers, who are skating out of Gothenburg in Sweden. So they say this is the third, fourth place game. So Dock City, we saw them yesterday, they played against Newcastle Roller Girls and they defeated Newcastle Roller Girls, which put them into the game this morning against Dublin, which was a super tight game.
Incredible game. If you missed out on that game, it came down all the way down to the last jam with trading blows throughout for both teams.
It was a point-for-point game, but just pipped by Dublin in the final jam, which gave Dublin the win and put them into the final. So we'll see them next on BBC Sport. And we've got Tiger Bay, who came in yesterday. They beat Central City Roller Girls, one of the local teams. But lost to the number one seed Callio this morning, who again are going on to face Dublin later on this evening in that final matchup.
Yep, so only one of these teams will be taking a medal home. The others will be just going home with the pride that they brought with them. So it's going to be a hard-fought game. It's going to be a well-placed game. We've seen a lot of defensive play, a lot of really good offensive play from both sides, and some fantastic jammer action. Shall we take you through the rosters of the two teams who are participating in this game?
If you'd like to take us in with the number three seed, Dock City.
I will do indeed. Dock City will be taking part today in navy blue. And on the track is 101 Mad Maxime, number 11 Fraulein F. Reckless, number 12 Pelvis Wrestley, number 14 Spinosaurus, number 18 Bowden, number 2 Olian, number 21 Fredelicious, number 26 Evil Danettes, number 31 Malice Babs, number 33 Force Majeure, number 414 A Crusher, number 417 Tina Turner, number 421 Patty from the Block, number 48 Moran. And that is their list of players for this game.
And they'll be facing off against the Tiger Bay Brawlers, skating in the orange with black accents. Their lineup is 10 Top Gun, 147 is Nitrogen, 15 is Dos Santos, 19 Steph Howarth, 271 Peb, 31 is Plant, 316 Thrill Collins, 40 Kid Block, 44 Billy Pistol, 453 is Attila Lahan, 59 is Wild, 6 is Chantel, 62 is Pip Gray, 81 is Angie, and 88 is Kemp. So that'll be the lineup for Tiger Bay Brawlers as we get into this game. About 26 seconds to go before the game starts. Final time for the teams to get their first lineups sorted, ready for this first and opening jam of our third, fourth playoff bronze medal game here at the European Continental Cup.
As we said, we're looking forward to this being a very good, very tight game. Dock City have brought some really tight play into this. Tiger Bay have been showing some excellent gameplay as well. So do keep yourselves tuned. Keep this roller derby action going on in the background and keep listening in to us.
So just getting some last minute preparation here from the officials, just checking in with the bench managers.
We will get ourselves a notification, rolling whistle, to state that the track is available, as has been displayed by our non-skating official. Team's now got 30 seconds to line up. And we will get a 5-second warning just before the gameplay is ready to go. So we have for Dock City, Malice Babs, who is their jammer. Up at the front in the bright orange, we can see number 19, Steph Howarth for Tiger Bay, pushing up against that Dock City wall. Malice Babs being knocked to the infield, taken back just behind the front jammer line, sorry, the pivot line. As we get into turn number one, Dos Santos trying to knock Malice Babs. Malice Babs taken to that inner field, and still we have Steph Howarth pushing up at the front of the pack.
Pip Gray from Tiger Bay doing a great job both times there, both moves initiated by Pip Gray to force that recycle from Malice Babs.
Pack starting to stretch out.
Out of play called at the back, so that have to move up to bridge that gap. However, did so without letting Steph Howarth get any movement. Sorry, Malice Babs get any movement forward in the pack.
Steph getting a little bit of a push through, but unfortunately rolls out, has to recycle back in. And Tiger Bay are down to just four blockers as Dos Santos is in the penalty box for a forearm penalty. Bit of space at the front, but Steph Howarth is not able to take it. Both teams really locked in hard here, Sven.
Yeah, so we're getting kind of two static mini groups. Of skates, still obviously maintaining that pack cohesion, so that they're looking to send some offense back now, I think, Dock City.
Yeah, the pack is close enough for them to do so. And that is Patty from the block in there to try and break out some space. A Crusher up at the front, just pushing through. This is a long time to go. We're almost to the last 20 seconds now without either of the jammers having broken for leads. This is an incredible force show of defensive play. 10 seconds left remaining in this two-minute jam. No lead has been called.
Tiger Bay losing another blocker for a direction of gameplay penalty.
Oh my word.
And another blocker. So Tiger Bay starting off three blocker penalties, a multiplayer block called on Pip Gray right in the end of the jam. So Tiger Bay going to be starting off with a disadvantage. Two blockers to four. But it does look like we've got Kid Block lining up against Fraulein Freckless. Kid Block, of course, a very powerful jammer with all that blocking experience as well that Kid Block's accrued over the years. So knows exactly what blockers are going to do. And as we've just seen, they're able to use those long legs to step around the outside, pick up lead for Tiger Bay.
Forearm penalty issued out to Tiger Bay means that they are down to just one blocker on the track as Fraulein Freckless comes back round. Kidbot calling that jam to an end.
So I think there was Thrill Collins was the only blocker left on track. And Tiger Bay are going to start with a single blocker on the track with one sitting.
Kid Block returning back to the jam line for Tiger Bay to do two jams in a row.
So we're going
to
see two. We're going to see Pip Gray and it looks like it's Kemp are going to be coming straight on within less than 10 seconds, both standing in the penalty box ready to come on. Of course, they're going to have to come on behind all those Dock City players. So unless that pack moves forward, they're going to have to move backwards to do that. And we get Moran is out first, picks up lead.
Oh, some really good work there by Tina Turner, knocking Kid Block out, taking a hit but staying on her toes herself to recycle Kid Block back. But Kid Block there with a dance around on the toe stops on that inside line manages to break through. Moran taken down to the ground by Chantel. And that call off forced by Tiger Bay. But Dock City collecting 4 points and they now jump into the lead. Points are now 4 points to Dock City, 1 point to Tiger Bay Brawlers. We're coming up to just about 5 minutes gone in this game.
And we'd expect this game to be close. So this is the number three seed versus the number four seed coming to this tournament. And also coming to this tournament, we've got number 49 ranked in the Wftda versus number 51 ranked in the Wftda. And again, the other thing with these two teams is they've never faced each other before. So we haven't got any past or recent history that we can go off for which team's going to have the advantage. So right now I think the first few jams are going to them feeling each other out and we might get to see some scores breaking away, maybe the gap opening up as we get further into this first period.
Yeah. In the meantime, a very defensive game from both sides. We saw that first jam with no lead jammer, but this is now Tiger Bay, two jams in a row as Billy Pistol picks up lead. Coming back round to the pack now, which is on turn number one, just as Malice Babs with the attempted break but picks up a cut penalty. So Tiger Bay now have a power jam for Billy Pistol. Billy Pistol just trying to squeeze around the outside, does so, going sideways round. That's a grand slam, 5 points for Tiger Bay. Tiger Bay down to just three blockers on the track, but uses those blockers to push through and break apart the Dock City wall. Tiger Bay dropped to the back to try and hold Dock City's pivot off the track. Well, Billy Pistol calls that jam to an end, having collected another set of 5 points. Really strong jam there for Tiger Bay. Here we see a replay of that action at the front. Billy Pistol just taken down to the ground. Dock City recycling back round. That's Ollian for Dock City. Not quite able to stop, but does just get that little catch on Billy Pistol.
So it looks like we've got Angie for Tiger Bay starting in the power start. Pack's already rolling over the pivot line into turn two as we get Malice Babs released from the penalty box and straight into the back of Dos Santos, who just shrugs Malice Babs to the infield.
Big hit to take in the early seconds of a jam, knowing you still got to power on through. Angie still pushing up at the front. Just got to try and get past the last blocker for Dock City, which she does do. It's a little hand not able to hold it back. Sorry, force majeure, but that is a forearm penalty on Angie. So a power jam. Oh no, that's a switch out. So both jammers being issued penalties. They sit the minimum amount of time they need to, depending on the other jammer, and release back into the track.
I think there was about a 3 second penalty there for each jammer. Obviously, so now we're going to go the full regulation 2 minutes. Both jammers having sat in the box, and of course I don't think we'd had lead established before either jammer had gone off, so no lead was gained to be lost. However, the ability is now gone as we get Malice Babs breaks the pack for the initial pass.
Malice Babs now hitting the back of the pack, has managed to overtake Angie already. Of course, being able to score on the opposition jammer as you come through the pack. Angie, however, with a knockout and drags Malice Babs back on the far straightaway. Pack starts to reverse back around turn number three to meet the jammers. And with Malice Babs having completed that pass back in front of Angie. Angie, of course, still on an initial pass. Malice Babs on a scoring pass, goes around the outside, taken down to the ground. Some very good work there by Tiger Bay to recycle and set back around. Dos Santos back in the penalty box for a directional penalty. Tough jam.
And it's obviously, you can see, so we're still, only one team has gotten a double-digit score yet. Just managed to duck under there, as we see in the replay. And that was where we saw the forearm, so I think there was a bit of a grasp on the back of the shirt of the Dock City blocker that aided with the pass.
Foul line at Freckless pushing up. Out of play is called, and lead jammer going to Dock City's foul line, F. Reckless. Some really good offensive play, resulting in a penalty for Dock City. But they do have the advantage of being lead jammer. Foul line, F. Reckless, lovely dart through, picks up a grand slam pass. But Plant is chasing round now, 30 feet behind the Dock City jammer, as that pack starts to move from turn two round to turn three on the far straight. Dos Santos holding Fraulein F. Reckless. It's a no pass, no penalty. And Fraulein takes the outside line. Oh, my word, did you see that? Duck down underneath on the inside line for Plant. Tiger Bay now picking up points as well.
So we're finally getting to see some actual points getting put on the board here for Dock City. Already had more than doubled their score from the previous 9 minutes of play with a single jam. And as I said, this is, I think, what we might see with these two teams early on in this game. We're going to see them where they're going to be feeling each other out, they're going to be trying to identify weak spots in the walls, work out their jammer matchups to the opposition jammers or the opposition blockers, and then try and balance the game out, try and make it work to their favour, see what the pace is like, see which pace the team prefers. And now we're starting to see some points going on the board, and I think as we go into the rest of this period, we might see some bigger scoring jams coming in.
Yeah, definitely with that first completely Lee Jamalus jam, both teams just really trying to impress the opposition on how strong their defence was. Look at that work, just absolutely having to fight through Bowden, scrambling past not only the Tiger Bay wall, but through her own defensive wall as well. Jam is now half a lap away from each other, and it's Bowden into the pack, scrambling around the inside. It looked almost like rock climbing the way that Bowden was getting through. Picks up another set of 4 points, taking Dock City to 26 points, Tiger Bay on 15.
So already in the game, you know, after seven jams, Tiger Bay are currently sitting, they've got 11 penalties spread out across the team over quite a few players. Dock City still only sitting on 4 penalties, and I think that's something that if Tiger Bay can rein in those penalties and keep more wheels on track, they're going to be able to make those walls more solid and stop Dock City getting through. And with jammers like Kid blocking the rotation, where they can concentrate, the blockers can concentrate more on the defence, we'll see Kid Block doing what Kid Block does best and just powering through those Dock City walls.
So Moran, aware Kid Block was right behind them, has a quick look around, goes into that pack backwards and calls it, not quite able to get the hips around. So a 0-0 jam for the two teams. So we have got 18 minutes left to play in this period. Dock City Rollers, who are playing in the navy blue, are on 26. Tiger Bay Brawlers in the orange are on 15 points. Just a quick replay of that lead run there, as we saw. And we're jumping into jam number 9. Fraulein F. Reckless with a lovely dance around the outside. Picks up lead jammer. Billy Pistol also tries to go for that dance around the inside line, but drops back to be defensive play to hold Fraulein F. Reckless behind. A knockout to the infield on both jammers. Ends up with a directional penalty being issued to Dock City's blocker.
So we get two blocker penalties ending for Tiger Bay. And again, it comes down to, as I said, the amount of time they're blocking and spending in the box and giving them reduced lineups, as we do get a star pass.
And we also get a cut penalty for Fraulein Freckless, an apex jump, but it wasn't successful. So that star pass over to Chantel now, only jammer on the track. Chantel having picked up a set of 5 points. Slides around that outside line. It's a call from the coach to carry on playing. Time is about up for Fraulein F. Reckless as Chantel comes into that pack. A little bit of the inside line cleared, but Dock City trying to close it down. Oh, good work. Chantel just jumping through that incoming hit from Peb. And a good slice through by Fraulein F. Reckless to break on initial, oh, not the initial pass, I do apologise, now on the second scoring pass. Comes around on the third.
Tried to keep that left foot in bounds, but just made out of bounds contact with the floor. Forced to recycle, but back up and running. Speeds out the pack for a lapping pass.
Oh. So that apex jump over will have picked up points, but also picked up a penalty as Fraulein F. Reckless landed into the back of the Tiger Bay blocker.
It looked like it was being called as a forearm penalty. That's what the jammer referee was signalling. And we're getting an official review called by the Tiger Bay bench. So while we're waiting for that to be discussed, just to give a shout out to the Women's Flat Track Derby Association, which is the international governing body of roller derby. You can find out more about how to play, where to play, and about our over 400 member leagues at wftda.com/new. There are leagues all over the world. Wherever you are watching from, whichever city or country you're in, if you have a look there, you'll probably find a league within a decent proximity to you.
And if there is a league, Dock City are requesting that we overturn the forearms call on their jammer at the end of the jam. Thank you.
Okay, so the that actual official review has been called by Dock City, not by Tiger Bay. I thought I saw the Tiger Bay bench showing an official review signal as well, coming at the middle. So
there's the potential for both to be discussed. The one that's being discussed now is Dock City, and Tiger Bay may or may not decide to continue with their official review, depending on the outcome. So yes, as Sven was saying, there are many derby leagues around. Do keep your eyes peeled. Have a check around to find one close to you. There's many different roles that people can get involved with in roller derby. You might fancy being an announcer, coming and appearing on WFTDA.TV and the BBC.
Or you could train up to be a referee, and we're going to get here Alice now.
Hi. The forearms call will stand. Dock City have used their official review for this period.
So there you go. So Dock City gamble the official review there just to see if they can get their forearms overturned. So they've now got 50 and a half minutes of the first period without their official review to fall back on.
And we start with the power start with kick block going in. Tiger Bay setting up at the back. Provide that inside line sweep, and Kid Block slails through fairly easily for Lee Jammer. Tiger Bay currently on 34 behind Dock City's 43. Kid Block is going to look to see if that can be extended back up. Does some wonderful darting work around the outside, has to get around Patty from the block. Goes to the outline line, a good slow down, but no hold on Kid Block. A set of 5 points added to Tiger Bay's score. Fraulein F. Reckless has been released from the penalty box. Has star in hand. Lovely apex leap. Almost unseen as Kid Block went hard into the back of that pack and taken down to the ground. So Kid Block on a second scoring pass at Fraulein F. Reckless. Going round for a first. And I believe points will have been picked up there.
Yeah, it looks like 2 points being signalled for Dock City. 4 point pickup by Kid Block. So the score is still very close now, 45 to Dock City, 43 to the Tiger Bay Brawlers.
We are into the second quarter of this game. These half hour of gameplay times, the clock will only be stopped for official reasons. Going in hard and heavy into the back of the pack was Bowden, and that worked out well as lead has been given to Dock City. Angie's still fighting through, looking to pass to Chantel. Chantel takes that star. Successful star pass. And Chantel now coming around as Bowden is locked up at the back of the pack. Some really good offensive play. Oh, no. Bowden realizing that call-off was late, and that is 2 points apiece. Some really good pressure there by Tiger Bay.
So it does nothing to the differential, but it does put 2 points onto each team's score. 47 plays, 45. Dock City with the narrowest of leads. And that seems to be most of the games this weekend have been at one point. At one point they've been a 2 point game which has gone back and forward between like lead changes. We've already had 4 lead changes so far in the game, 2 apiece.
So we now have Moran and Steph Howard. Moran finds space on the outside, goes round her own their own pack, and picks up lead jammer. Steph Howard stuck at the back, trying to pass the star through that melee of persons, and does so. We now have Thrill Collins jamming for Tiger Bay.
And that was 2 successive hits from Top Gun. The first one just took the speed. And the second one was just a static, just pushed to the inside line. Strong block in there from Tiger Bay.
We're going to see Billy Pistol up against Fraulein F. Reckless. Fraulein knocking Billy Pistol to the infield, but carries on trying to fight through that pack. Space on the outside. No, it is closed down. Run back by Chantel. Dos Santos trying to basically pull Billy Pistol around. The space at the front as Tiger Bay are drawn into a line. And Lee Jammer now going to Dock City's Fraulein F. Reckless. Fraulein F. Reckless into the back of the pack. Oh, taking down Billy Pistol. That was a tough one to do. Not expecting the jammer to come in and hit you whilst you are pushing into their wall. But a recycle back by Tiger Bay puts them at the back of the pack now to hold Fraulein Effreckless, who is on a scoring pass. Billy Pistol still looking to complete her initial pass.
And it's Top Gun and Pip Gray, who we've seen a lot throughout this game already, just being a nightmare for these Dock City jammers. And they're just kind of just being shored up by Dos Santos at the front,
who is currently providing defense and offense at the same time. Oh, big hit by Dos Santos. One hand down is not out. And Fraulein F. Reckless carries on through.
Looks like a low block is being issued. And that is to Chantel, the pivot for Tiger Bay. Dock City widening their lead a little bit as we get to a palindromic score, 54-45.
We've had a team timeout requested by Tiger Bay. So they're just going to gather their thoughts together. Just quickly, just reassess the situation. So there's a really good time for the teams to just come together, talk about what's working, talk about what's not working. They have their bench staff there who are viewing the game as a whole, who can give feedback through as well. And of course, the jammers can discuss with each other and to the rest of the team what kind of approaches they would like to have. It's a time for the opposition teams to also reflect on what they're doing. So Dock City aren't just going to wait for this time out. They're going to have their own discussions, decide what they're doing themselves as well.
And it's a time for us to thank you for joining us here live on the BBC Sport website and on WFTDA.TV. And if you're curious about what makes a back block, track cut and some of the other penalties and rules, visit WFTDA.com/new. That's N-E-W for a downloadable roller derby cheat sheet. Maybe we should get one of those.
It would be very handy. So that 1 minute timeout has now ended. We're ready to jump into jam number 14, which sees Kid Block up against Bowden.
Strong wall at the back.
Both jammers taking the inside line, but Bowden knocked out. Tiger Bay just trying to push at the Kibbutz just trying to push at the front. Like those two offensive players just basically maintaining the pack for a short while.
And that was Nitrogen is just trying to provide some support for Kid Block before then switching back to defense again.
Some really good offensive play and big hits coming through by a Crusher for Dock City. But Kid Block spinning around on the toe stops, stays in, and that's lead jammer. It's taken, however, 45 seconds. And we're going to call that jam to an end.
So Bowden, who the jammer for Dock City, dropped away from the track and has gone down on the outfield looking injured. So I think that might have been a call off for injury because we've gone to an official timeout.
Yep. Not called off by Kid Blockers, who we can see here picking up lead jammer. Did not signal for that jam to end. So we are taking an official timeout whilst we attend to the injured player. This is one of the few times when the clock will stop and pause. It's currently paused at 9 minutes 40 seconds to go in this half. And the point still standing at Dock City Rollers on 54 points, Tiger Bay Brawlers on 45. And if you are just joining us, Dock City are playing in that navy blue, as you can see on your screens right now. Tiger Bay are in the orange with black accents.
And if you're watching at home and you want to see all the scores and get the play-by-play, if you're one of these people who can watch the game on the TV and keep up with everything on Twitter, check out at WFTDA Live for the up-to-date scores. And if, of course, you want to have your say and have a good chat about the games as they're playing, make sure you use hashtag talk, the number 2, WFTDA. That's hashtag talk 2, WFTDA.
So we're just receiving a round of applause. Our injured skater is now back on their feet. Sven, this has been a very locked down game. It's quite, for those of you who are fairly new to roller derby, this is still quite a low scoring game so far. 54 playing 45. We're seeing some very quick get points and call off. So low scoring jams where jammers are only getting the 4 or 5 points before calling. Some very very good responses as well. There are a couple of jams where jammers are scoring the same amount, so we're getting neutral jams in. So it's a very locked down game.
Yeah, see, I mean, these teams are closely ranked and closely seeded for a reason. However, that doesn't stop sometimes players like Billy Pistol from just whipping up that inside line, picking up lead for Tiger Bay.
We're looking at an attempt for a star pass from Dark City, but both jammer and pivot knocked off and recycled to the back, so it's going to make it hard. Olyan, the pivot for Dock City with the hands behind trying to get that star pass from Maron. Tiger Bay just settling in. Billy Pistol just pushing on through. That was just determination. Looks up at the board, sees how close Tiger Bay are now.
And we've had the star pass to Olyan. Still got the pivot stripe visible, but the star is in hand. And just getting rolled to the outside. Billy Pistol is going to get through and we'll get the lead change in the lap.
Dos Santos not quite able to hold Olyan, who breaks around turn number 4 and can now come through on a scoring pass. Billy Pistol, however, in full control, still lead jammer. Hopping, skipping. Is that in? I'm not sure.
It's definitely Billy Pistol's definitely favouring the left foot.
Yeah.
So I saw Bowden come back to the bench after that injury stoppage. It looked like one of our fabulous EMTs here was just explaining to the bench. I think it was a hit to the ribs. It was winding. So Bowden has got to sit out for 3 jams anyway. But they look like they're going to be able to return to play anyway at some point. It doesn't seem like it's an injury that's going to take them the game. They're back in the lineup chairs in front of us with the star on the helmet. So we should see Bowden back in a few jams' time.
That's good to hear and good to know. Fighting up at the front at the moment, Steph Howard for Tiger Bay. Skips around that inside line on the out-of-play call and picks up lead jammer for the team in orange. Around the back, Pelvis Wrestling now. New jammer in for Dock City. As Steph Howarth goes in too hard and heavy and picks up a high block penalty against Tina Turner. And this is now a power jam for Pelvis Wrestley, the new jammer for Dock City. Pushes through that inside line, starting to pick up points now. Dock City really happy to see. I'm assuming Pelvis Wrestley has jumped into the space that Bowden would normally be on that rotation as a replacement jammer.
Yeah, it looks like it would have been about time where Bowden would be coming back in, but obviously, as we said, Bowden's got to sit out for those injury for the delay of game for the injury.
Pelvis Wrestley just being super careful, super cautious, comes back on all the way around. Oh, we've gone back to turn number 2 for Pelvis Wrestley from turn number 4. Really good recycle back there by Tiger Bay, and that has burned down the time that Steph Howarth has spent in the penalty box.
Yeah, some lovely work from Wild there, just judging exactly how much engagement zone you can use while recycling the jammer.
Points apiece, so we're both in scoring position. There's 25 seconds left of play in this jam. Steph Howarth coming around for a second scoring pass, just held up by the 3 wall at the back. And Pelvis Wrestling just taking a shirt whip around, but Tiger Bay closing down now on turn number 4. That inside line looking very cluttered. And the space around the outside line, Steph Howarth finds it and races off as that drawback on Pelvis Wrestley means that both jammers, having completed 2 scoring passes. However, sorry, I do apologise, Dock City being awarded a 3rd scoring pass for the Pelvis Wrestley. They finished the jam with 12 points. Tiger Bay finished the jam with 8.
So 60-60-64, still 2 points in it. 5.5 minutes left of period 1. And I'm not going to try and fall down on one side here as to which side's going to be victorious at the end of period 1.
It could still go every way. But going straight ahead and straight into lead is Fraulein F. Reckless. for Dock City. Kid Block, however, with the jump through that inside line, breaks away as Fraulein Freckles comes into a very small pack. Tiger Bay split quite far apart, but a good pullback by Pip Gray forces that call off before Kid Block can pick up points. Any points for Dock City? They're just being discussed in the middle.
Yeah, it looks like we've got 3 points shown for Dock City. It's a 5 point game.
With less than 5 minutes to go.
And we've got Plant for Tiger Bay in the orange, lining up against Moran in the dark, the navy blue for Dock City. Both straight into the scrum.
Yeah, Moran going instantaneously as that whistle was sounded. Just manages to squeeze around the sandwiching from Tiger Bay at the front. But Moran just wrapped around to try and break through. Goes really low. And that is Nitrogen picking up the penalty for Tiger Bay. However, recycle has already occurred. And that space at the front for Plant means Tiger Bay pick up lead jammer. Plant coming around now on a scoring pass as that recycle still happening, being pulled back on Moron. Plant just with the hips around. Doesn't stay on track.
Looks like we've got the cut track call being signaled from the outside. So power jam Dock City.
And with the star back on, the initial pass now completed. Dock City starting to pick up points in this jam. We've got 47 seconds left to capitalise. Tiger Bay all straight up, just forming a queue to block Moran. And in come Dock City to try and break that queue apart. They're queue busting right now. Nitrogen here now with the hold for Tiger Bay.
Power jam complete now as Plant is back to track and goes straight into the back of the pack hard, sends a Dock City blocker flying.
Both jammers now about neck and neck, pushing through the pack. Space at the front though, really good work there. I believe that's Nitrogen just acting as a bollard that the Dock City players had to break to get around. Oh, late call off. Means points picked up by Tiger Bay, but already 5 points for Dock City in that pass. Means 10 points to 8 in that jam. Still a close game. 79 for Dock City, 72 for Tiger Bay. We've got just over 2 minutes left in this period. And we're going to go to a timeout for Dock City. So all of that testing that we did in the first sort of 10 to 15 minutes, we can definitely see a little bit more of the risk-taking from both sides here. Jammer's really trying to push through. As we can see, not always successful. Tiger Bay picking up a fair ream of penalties. As you can see on your screen, there's quite a few who are sitting on 3 currently. Maximum you can have is 7 before you are fouled out of the game.
Yeah, and Tiger Bay double the number of penalties, so 24 to 12 penalties across the team. So that's just obviously not looking at specific jammer blocker penalties, but even just the fact we've seen a constant stream of Tiger Bay blockers coming to and from the box. If they had been able to keep those feet on track, you know that that Dock City wouldn't be currently winning in the race for lead. It's still only 9-7 that we've got here tracked. But they wouldn't be winning in that lead battle, and so they wouldn't be controlling the game as much as they are. And I think we might see in that instance Tiger Bay pulling ahead.
So both teams currently playing a 5 jammer main rotation, with 2 pivots having taken star passes. At the moment we are looking at Bowden for Dock City up at the front with that very solid 3-wall. There's space on the outside, but Bowden has to recycle back. And in the meantime, Angie is pushing through for Tiger Bay. Bowden finds the inside line, stays on wheels. Lee Jammer going to Dock City. Star pass over now. Chantel for Tiger Bay. Oh, and a lovely work there. That was definitely a squeezing through people whilst Christmas shopping style of jamming. Shoulders went through, hips followed, and it's the hips that score the points. Dock City picking up 4 in that jam.
And that's exactly what we were just saying there about the fact that Tiger Bay are not able to stop Dock City from getting lead, and that just means Dock City are in control. So they were able to shut out Tiger Bay again, you know, and put a couple of points on the ball themselves while Tiger Bay sit scoreless. So we had an illegal positioning there. Fraulein F. Reckless just jumped the gun slightly, completely over the jam line as the whistle blew.
Yeah.
I've been noticing that because we've got a good clear view of this jam line here. There's been a few jams where some of the Dock City jammers are going just milliseconds before the whistle to try and get that edge. And in that case, Fraulein F. Reckless just gambled a bit too much and got caught out in an illegal position.
Yeah, I'm not sure it's assisting because Tiger Bay are giving themselves the 5-second countdown out loud. And of course, if they're counting a little bit faster, it's going to put your own counting off. Kiss to the audience by Steph Howarth. We've got a very, very solid cheering squad here for both teams. Oh, Ollian with that final lockdown hit just stops that progression. Steph Howarth on his second scoring pass, but recycled around the entirety of turn number 3. Doesn't seem like a lot whilst you're looking at it, but I can guarantee you skating it round after having fought it is a long way. So the inside line is the better option this time around, and 4 points picked up by Steph Howarth. Tina Turner now, having taken the star pass, is the jammer for Dock City. And with a 4-on penalty being issued, just one more blocker to get past, which she does so. So Dock City having broken their initial pass. Tiger Bay looking to pick up a few more points. Are they going to run this? They are indeed. Tina Turner, oh, 1 foot around the outside line, picks up a full set of 4 points. Tiger Bay, however, looking to get that additional scoring pass.
Great hit from Patty from the block. Just sends Steph Howarth to the outside, recycled all the way back to the penalty box straight.
Two more points picked up by Tiger Bay for a 15-point jam playing to an 8-point jam by Dock City. So Dock City ending this half on 91 points, 4 points ahead of Tiger Bay Brawlers, who are on 87.
So, as we said there, it's been a close game all the way through, and it's ended close in this first period. So we might as well have just not bothered with that and gone straight to the second period here, I think.
But as you said, Sven, they are looking to just sort of work each other out. First time they've played against each other. So the first half really just kind of testing the boundaries with each of the teams. Second half, I can see we're going to go in quite solid and see a little bit more of the action we expect from these two teams.
Yeah, I think Tiger Bay have got to go into the bench, into the changing room at halftime here, and they've got to address this penalty problem that they've got. No one's in actual any penalty trouble. I think the most we've got is 3, but we've got a good spread of 3 penalties across a lot of the blockers, and they do seem to be getting the penalties in pairs. Often we're seeing Tiger Bay with 2 blockers in the box, or sometimes even 3 blockers in the box. We've had 2 jams there where they've been down to a single blocker. However, Dock City just seem to be doing right by their blockers seem to be staying on track and staying in the way of the Tiger Bay jammers, and I think that's why Dock City seem to be getting out and getting lead a bit more and controlling the game a bit more. But it's not giving them that much of an edge. I think we've only got 4 points in it now.
Yep, and there's only been an extra 2 leads for Dock City over Tiger Bay, so it's not working in their favour every single time. However, these penalties may come in to haunt Tiger Bay in the second period.
Indeed, so we've got another 13 minutes or so before the second period, but right now we're going to go and throw you to a video that we made. We've talked a lot about the blocker stats in the opening period, because I say we've talked about the blocker penalties, and we've looked at the stats going back and forth in terms of the number of blockers I've had, you know, on track at any one time. But we've been having a look at some of the jammer statistics over the half-time interval.
Yeah, some interesting figures coming through. We're seeing, looking at Tiger Bay, we're seeing a spread across a number. They've actually had 5 rotation jammers, but with 2 Pivots having taken star passes, they've got a total of 7 players with Jammer statistics. None of them have had more than a 50% lead. So that doesn't mean taking lead 50% of the time. It means the time they've been as a Jammer, they've got lead 50% of their own time, which is quite low, but obviously means that you're fighting back. So to be able to have this score, not having had control for less than half, having had control for less than half the game as your Jammers, is a really good comeback for Tiger Bay to prove that they can still score points when they are not in lead. Highest Jammers are currently shared between Billy Pistol and Chantel. Chantel, of course, going on as a pivot to Jammer and not as a main rotation Jammer.
Yeah, we're seeing those both 21 points each out of that 87 score that Tiger Bay currently have. However, you look at the Dock City Rollers, you'll see they have got a decent spread of Jammers, but again, we've got some pivots showing up on there that kind of don't show the same kind of stats in terms of the lead percentage, etc. But if you look at some of the key Jammers that Dock City have been relying on, like Fraulein F. Reckless and Bowden, who obviously we've seen come back from that injury and as if there was nothing happening in the middle of that period, and Moran, they're both sitting on 67, 75 and 60% lead average for themselves for when they've been on track. And we've seen Fraulein F. Reckless has got a 40-point tally against that total of 91 for Dock City. So just under half of the Dock City points can be chalked up to that number 11, Fraulein F. Reckless.
Yeah, Bowden having picked up 75% lead, only 10 points, but that means that the control is still there with Dock City. They're currently in control of this game, as we said, just a handful of points away from Tiger Bay, which is easily done. In roller derby, one single scoring pass can award you up to 5 points. So they are a pass away from each other currently as we're looking to go into the second period of this game.
However, the one thing that, again, jumps out is you look at the power jam. So Dock City have enjoyed the pleasure of 3 power jams. I know we had that odd little 3-second power jam, which was the only one that Tiger Bay have had. So we've obviously had 2 opportunities there where Dock City have been able to get on and rack up the points. And they've also had a slight advantage in terms of lead. It's kind of sitting like 60-40 lead for Dock City right now, so they've just had that little controlling edge. But I guess that's reflected in the score that we've got right now. There's 91-87. It's going to be hard to put anything between these two teams. And I know that in the change rooms there, they're going to have been analysing. The teams at this level have got people running the same stats that we're kind of running now. They've got access to the same stats that we've got. They're going to be looking at this and they're going to be coming back. So we might see some different tactics. We might see teams trying to change just the pace of the game maybe to suit their style more, because it's very easy as a team sometimes to get drawn into the play style that suits the other team.
Yes.
It suits your opponent. And I think that's what they'll be discussing in the change rooms now, is how we can switch it up a bit, how we can change it, how we can break the deadlock that we're currently stuck in here between these two teams.
Yeah, and another point of action that they might be looking at, a lot of teams do track what we call hotspots, so places Jammers are managing to escape and looking to lock down on those hotspots. I think Tiger Bay in particular, the outside line is very favoured by their Jammers because they are strong enough and fast enough to break ground, whereas Dock City doing a lot of those apex leaps, getting up through that inside line. So I think the two teams are perhaps going to have to switch themselves around to cover those hotspots and ensure the other Jammers aren't breaking through.
Yeah, I mean, I think we've also seen a few, I think the last few, like last 10 minutes of the game, that first period, Dock City looked like they were trying to go more for it, getting lead straight out of the gate, and that's why we had that illegal positioning. The false start penalty issued to, I believe it was
Fraulein
F. Reckless who got the illegal positioning, because they are just trying to get that extra run, especially when we've got the pack on the jam line. However, now pack is all up at the pivot line, so the Jammers are going to get a bit of a run-up into this first jam of period 2.
Yeah, we're seeing Bowden going straight in, knocked to the outside line, and it's Steph Howarth in reply for Tiger Bay, who's just trying to push up through the inside, so instantly the Jammers going the opposite sides to which they would have normally gone. Cutting penalty issued to Chantel for Tiger Bay. Means there is some space at the front for Bowden, who's knocked to the infield, gets around Dos Santos, and that's lead Jammer now to Dock City. Tiger Bay down to just the 2 blockers on track, no pivots, and despite Steph Howarth holding the star in hand, she cannot pass. Dock City come around and swarm around that Tiger Bay wall. and both jammers breaking out.
That was a lovely little move there. Steph Howarth actually pushed Dos Santos forward, split two Dock City blockers, and then followed Dos Santos through to emerge out and obviously be able to get through and complete that initial pass. And again, sometimes even if you don't, get lead, your focus should be get your jammer out and put pressure on the other team to call off the jam before they can rack up any points.
No, definitely. You've got to just try and stop them scoring any points if you can do. So either way, you've just got to slow it down and clog it down as quickly and as efficiently as you can do. Moran trying to go for that pull round on her own player, so grabbing the shirt of her own player to pull around, but Kid Block knocking her out, and it's now Kid Block for Tiger Bay, who has picked up lead jammer. Tiger Bay back up now to a set of four blockers on the track as Kid Block comes into the pack, calls that jam to an end with a 0-0 score. So both jammers so close to each other, Kid Block taking the safer route and calling that jam to an end. Just 9 points between the two teams.
Now, we saw there Moran try to take the shirt whip right off the jam line and held on to the shirt for a while. Got to be very careful with that, because as soon as someone challenges that link, you will get assessed the multiplayer penalty. So that's a very dangerous thing. And if Tiger Bay see that, they can take the advantage of that and actually challenge that link.
They
to
can
try and
do.
Force the jammer penalty.
It is a quick one that you have to be very aware of. And it is something that Dock City have been utilising quite a lot throughout this game. They're basically putting an offensive play in alongside the brace player for the triangle wall. And that offensive player is just there as literally a bollard to hold onto and throw themselves around. Steph Howarth picked up lead in this jam. We heard all that action happening up there on turn number two. 3 points for Tiger Bay, but 1 point picked up by Dock City. What's Tiger Bay on 90 points, Dock City on 97. Tiger Bay setting up at the back. You can see Dock City there in the navy blue up at the front. And we're going to see Tiger Bay's Kid Block up against Dock City's Bowden. Kid Block going for that outside line, switches around the inside, rolls twice and picks up lead jammer, but Bowden has skipped through and is racing around that outside line, 30 feet behind Kid Block as that pack pushes its way through to turn number two. Dock City with two blockers at the back. Kid Block trying to knock Bowden off, but actually knocks Bowden into the pack. Bowden now around the outs, infield, inside line as Kid Block spins around. Well, both jammers having completed an initial pass, but Bowden is now ahead and coming in for pass number two.
So Kid Block missed the opportunity to call off the jam before Bowden got in, and now being signaled, just keep it moving, because you need to actually try and do something to get an advantage. This is where they need to try and contain Bowden so Kid Block can start getting out and getting the positive lap points over Bowden. So now we're seeing this here, so we might see Kid Block try another pass of the pack.
I would say so, as Bowden had, I think, almost passed everybody, if not had passed everybody. Recycled back in, has definitely now passed through everyone. So Kid Block is going to be looking to score on this pass and call, which she does do so.
Picks up an extra two. So that puts us back to a 5-point game, 105, players 100. Less than 5 minutes of the second period played now, 25 minutes and a half. Or 25 and a half minutes, how we say it in English, left to play in this period. So anything can still go on. And again, the teams are still now going to be getting back into stride after that half-time interval.
We just saw some beautiful blocking there on your replay by Ollian from Dock City, who was just holding Kid Block down. But see that agility from Kid Block to break through and get those points. Into jam number five now, we're going to see Angie and Moran darting around at the back. Angie just being pushed through on that inside line. Has she stayed in the track? She has, with a no pass, no penalty. Cannot pick up lead, so has not passed everybody. Lead goes to Moran, who calls it straight away to lock down Angie from scoring.
Tiger Bay going to be starting one down, with Kemp in the box. Looks like it was a forearm penalty that Kemp picked up. So 4-on-3 blocker advantage to Dock City. And I think we've seen more of a shift towards the pivot line, although Dock City are rolling back now. Actually, we're going to be moving back to the jam line, just as I've said that.
Obviously. Tiger Bay wanting to set up at the front as they had the least amount of players on the track and they didn't want to get swarmed. But Fraulein F. Reckless knocked to the inside, hit to the outside, stays on rails, manages to stay on the track and picks up lead jammer. Really good jamming there by Dog City. Fraulein F. Reckless, however, this time takes a knock, is recycled back behind Thrill Collins, and Kid Block comes back in to be a defensive blocker and jammer at the same time. So Kid Block now bolstering the defensive ranks. It's not enough. And around Nitrogen at the front for another Grand Slam pass for Fraulein F. Reckless.
Air Crusher just trying to do some offense to get Fraulein F. Reckless out. And another one of those shirt whips. Tries to, I'm just going to say, matrix that out there in the toast off, but loses balance and touches out of bounds. Are going to be recycled all the way back here to the jam line.
Good drawback by Tiger Bay now, which gives space for Kid Block not having to play as a blocker, but up there as a jammer. Oh, wonderful work by Fraulein F. Reckless to just push through. And we have seen a star pass to Thrill Collins of Tiger Bay, who is still playing as a blocker despite having the star in hand. Stars look like that. Oh, ah, very clever. Stars have now gone on. And of course, the jammer does not have to remain within the pack. So Thrill Collins is doing a full pull round on Fraulein F. Reckless. Dangerous territory, however, with Dock City at the front. And now both jammers back on the track. Fraulein F. Reckless still in control. And there we see that call off by Dock City. Really good stop to scoring there. Might have played a little bit into Dock City's way of wanting to play. They are slightly in the lead, so they're not too worried about having to just wait. And of course, it gives the jammers on both sides a little bit of a rest. They don't have to go through those hits. There we see that matrix move. Didn't quite happen. A good hit, just enough power there by Nitrogen.
Well, that was the third attempt that Nitrogen had of putting a hit onto Fraulein F. Reckless and finally managed to make it stick. As we are back now with Moran for Dock City, jamming against Steph Howarth for Tiger Bay.
Steph Howarth with a solid three wall at the back. Oh, wow, darting through, but takes into the infield, and that's lead now for Moran. Steph Howarth having removed, and there's a star pass straight over to Chance Hell, just as Moran hits the back of the pack, which is now rolling around to turn number three. A takedown by Kemp, and that forces the call off. 0 points for Tiger Bay, another three for Dock City. Dock City are starting to creep away with this one.
So we're finally starting to see more than a 5 point gap appearing between these teams. Score standing now 119 to 100 for Dock City. 21 minutes remaining in the game. As we get ready to go with, it looks like Plant for Tiger Bay is going to be jamming against Bowden for Dock City.
Space on the outside for Bowden, and Bowden just manages to keep just enough ahead of Wild to pick up Lee Jammer. Star pass attempt to Thrill Collins. It's not successful, and Thrill goes back into defense, but is unable to hold Bowden, and that star pass is looking to possibly go ahead now. And Thrill Collins comes back to provide more defensive play. Bowden taken down to the ground. Good hold there by Tiger Bay. And there is a break for Plant. Bowden calling that jam from the floor.
Team timeout called by Tiger Bay. Still got one remaining and an official review. Dock City still have their two timeouts and an official review for the period.
And to keep you notified of the officials who are participating in this game, we have both on-skates officials, referees, and non-skating officials. Our skating officials are Alice, Baff, Rolling Rat, Kilobyte, Quadslaw, Bully Hayes, Fair Enough, and Mass.
And our NSOs for this game are Crystal Vice, Ragnarok, Lola Rock and Roller, Pussy Panzerfaust, Riff Ref, Joe Kerr, Door Ian Gray, Strange Edge, Animal, Mina Harker, Stegosaurus and Hannah. And they're the ones that are obviously feeding us the information via the whistles and hand signals so that we know what's going on the track.
And we are feeding that all back to you. Thank you for joining us here. Whether you are listening in on BBC Sport website or through WFTDA.tv, we are grateful for you to be listening in and supporting the 2018 European Continental Cup. Kid Block with space at the front, dangerous around the outside line, spins around that inside line, had already picked up lead but is now broken free and able to come around on a scoring pass. Dos Santos in conjunction with Wild doing a good pullback on Fraulein F. Reckless. It's not often they're able to lock down and get lead over Fraulein, so a really good jam here for Tiger Bay. Fraulein having to star pass to Ollion, and that star pass has been completed. Kid Block comes in for a second scoring pass. I can hear the Tiger Bay bench saying to run it as Ollion does an apex jump. How did they stay on track? That was some really, really good play by Ollion to not get knocked to the infield.
Tiger Bay having no option but to shut that jam down. They still have a pickup of four. Gives them 9 in total for the jam, bring the score to 132. Dock City Roller, Dock City Rollers versus Tiger Bay Brawlers 109. Just 19 minutes remaining in the game. So interesting thing there, when Tiger Bay got the pack set up near the pivot line and gave and had spaced out a bit more, it was much easier for them to get through. When they get drawn in like they are now by Dock City, Dock City seem much better at getting off the line in that scrum start and giving the offense for their jammers to push them forward. So we can see now we've got Bowden already at the front challenging that three wall of Tiger Bay, while the remainder of the Dock City blockers are just holding around Steph Howard, who tries the shirt whip and throws Chantel to the outfield.
We're going to use your tricks against you here. Chantel just providing some inside defense. And again, there goes that shirt whip. And it is enough to give Tiger Bay momentum. Steph Howarth picking up lead jammer. Bowden still stuck in that pack, as we can see. Pack resets itself on the far straightaway. Bowden just taken down to the ground with a bit of a clutter happening. Multiplayer issued to Dock City's number 33, Force Majeure. And that's a grand slam unchallenged at the moment for Steph Howarth.
And now we have a reduced pack for Dock City. Two Dock City blockers, Tina Turner and Force Majeure in the box. Tina Turner just coming out now and following Steph Howarth into the engagement zone.
But it is Dos Santos up at the front who is holding back Bowden even as that pack stretches out. Not quite able to hold as we go from turn 3 to 4 just off your screen. And Tiger Bay now coming back to try and assist Steph Howarth to try and get the last set of points if possible before Bowden scores. And that call-off comes through. And 3 more points added to Tiger Bay's total.
So we're back to a 10-point game now. 132 plays 122. Still nearly 17 minutes remaining in the game though. So neither team here can sit back and defend this. I think they've got to fight for every point here to really widen this margin.
We've just seen on our screen that replay of Tiger Bay getting through and locking down on the opposition. They'll need to do that a few more times if they're able to get the lead back in their favour. We've got Kid Block. They used Source Fen, as you were saying, went for that shirt whip, realised that there was a dangerous territory there, did not want to get the multiplayer and instantly let go. Space on the outside. Oh, down. Is that safe? It is a cut penalty. So toe stop dragged on the outside and a pass of an opposition player means that we have a power jam now in favour of Kid Block. Kid Block, a very strong jammer for Tiger Bay.
So it looked like Moran there saw one Tiger Bay blocker going out and thought it was safe to come back to track, but hadn't realised that they had passed two more who were on the infield line. one of their own and an opposing blocker, and therefore obviously the cut was signalled.
Tiger Bay here currently holding back number 1-4 for Dock City, who is Spinosaurus.
And Spinosaurus picks up an out of play block for failing to heed the warning of the referee that they were out of play.
And a good shield by Tiger Bay means a 14-point jam for Kid Block, which, if you can hear through the ambient microphones, that is a lead change in favour of Tiger Bay Brawlers from Cardiff. 136 points to Tiger Bay. Dock City currently on 132, and we are just pausing on 15 minutes and 3 seconds left in this game as Dock City take one of their two remaining timeouts.
And we saw there that in those last couple of jams, Dock City had 4 or 5 blocker penalties in quick succession. Same thing we saw happen to Tiger Bay in the first period. So Dock City now need to put the lid on these blocker penalties, because we've just seen what Kid Block's been allowed to do with a power jam and reduced pack. Lead change already, 136-132 now Tiger Bay, 50 minutes remaining. They're obviously relying heavily on Kid Block here, but we can see Steph Howarth, who I think is second in number of jams, stepping up the line now for Tiger Bay. So going for a very solid, really two primary jammers here, yes, for Tiger Bay. Whereas Dock City spreading it nicely between three with Frauliner, Freckless, Bowden and Moran.
And Bowden only having less jams due to that injury. So Frauliner, Freckless pushing up, and there's space on the inside line. Steph Howarth just races through. Frauliner, Freckless now dancing around the outside. Dos Santos looking to hold at the front, and it's a little bit of a shuffle. But Frauliner, Freckless breaks just as we get a entry to the pack by Steph Howarth. Were there points collected? There were 3 more points for Tiger Bay.
So Tiger Bay now go on the lead streak, 4 in a row for Tiger Bay. And again, giving them the control, you can see how that control swings the momentum of the game.
Certainly has, and if they can carry this momentum through, even after having that timeout taken by the opposition team, if they can keep that momentum going. It's a long time to keep it going, though. Spend 14 minutes left in this game. Kid Block jumping through, goes around the outside, spins through, stays on track. Lead jammer now, Tiger Bay. We have Bowden now just trying to push through, shoulders first, but taken down on the outside, and it is a forearm penalty issued to Nitrogen of Tiger Bay. Kid Block trying to get around the outside one more time, but is being held. Patty from the block just holding down and passing on to look around, and now bolstering that wall. In comes Bowden, pushes round. Star in hand, Stars now go back on top as Kid Block is being held on the inside line of turn number 2. Goes to see if they can get one more point, but it's already 4. How about 4? Have 4 points.
Kid Block there just drew that out as long as possible. Could just made eye contact with the bench coach and said, I got this, I can time this.
Here we see that wonderful turn. Just staying on, wonderful agility work, awareness of the line. Sublime from Kid Block there. Just manages to throw enough momentum through on the stoppers to stay on track. Steph Howarth back on the track for Tiger Bay. As we said, these two are almost trading jams between Steph Howarth and Kid Block. Lovely shirt whip off of Nitrogen, who comes out of the penalty box to give Steph Howarth lead jammer. I've never seen so many shirt whips in my life in one game.
Yeah, I'm surprised that any of these players have got any shirts left, and the ferocity of the shirt whips that they're actually taking.
But they are so effective. As we said, we're just seeing the teammates just sitting back into that wall and just allowing the jammer to literally just lift themselves around, holding onto their teammate's shirt. Pack has slowed down now on turn number 2 with Dock City at the back holding Steph Howarth on a scoring pass. Tiger Bay just coming into the straightaway with Moran, who is on their initial pass. Big break there. but it is Steph Howarth who gets the inside line. A crusher trying to get out Moran. Moran taken off, but there's a direction penalty going to Dos Santos for Tiger Bay. Steph Howarth going in just a little bit steadier now. A little bit of that speed's been taken off, but we have been 90 seconds into this jam as it stands. And there's been a lot of pushing. We are still on the far straight where the pack has been for the last 30 seconds. Oh, sneak around the outside. Oh, it's too far out, though. A cut penalty to Moran means we're going to finish this jam on a power jam for Steph Howarth, who calls that jam, but I don't think there was any time left on the clock anyway. A big thank you to the pivot, Chantel, from Steph Howarth. And 10 points added to Tiger Bay's lead. 153 Tiger Bay, 132 Dock City. We've got 10 and a half minutes left, and we can see that race there by Steph Howarth.
So Tiger Bay just continuing the streak of getting lead. I think they've finally sussed out what they've got to do to break Dock City to get through their blockers. And now we're going to 7 in a row for Tiger Bay.
If you notice from the packs, the blockers turn around to Kid Block when she's on a power jam, and they give hand signals to work out what type of play she wants them to do coming into that pack. There's another shirt whip for Moran to stay on track, just fighting through, taking a lot of blocks to the front as Kid Block has worked around for a scoring pass. We're going to see Tiger Bay lose a player to the penalty box, and that is Top Gurn. Kiblock not quite able to get through on there. That block slowed down. And Moran through. Tiger Bay 5, maybe 10 feet behind.
Kiblock just going to run this down a little bit more. So Tiger Bay burning a few seconds off the clock while they have this 31-point lead.
Yeah, they have an advantage points-wise. They were also looking to burn a few more seconds off of Top Gurn's penalty time as well. Very sensibly done from the team from Cardiff. Under 9 minutes remaining now in this game. You are watching the third place game here at the 2018 European Continental Cup, the inaugural Continental Cup in Europe. And the winners from this team will be taking home bronze medal. Winning lead, however, for this jam is Tiger Bay's Steph Howarth, who is one on, one off at the moment as a jammer for Tiger Bay alongside Kid Block. Of course, that jam to an end, picking up a single point, but a single point is all you need. If you're in control and you can stop the opposition from scoring.
So it looks as well that Dock City have also been held scoreless now since Jam 9. And we're just about to go into Jam 17. So Tiger Bay clearly have figured something out within this period.
As you said, Sven, we definitely felt the pendulum swing in Tiger Bay's favour despite Dock City taking a timeout. But Dock City now taking control with Bowden, lead jammer. And points will have been picked up by Dock City as Bowden's on a scoring pass now. Kid Block trying to get through that inside line, but knocked to the infield and taken back. Bowden with a grand slam.
So, of course, just as we talk about the lead streak for a team and the scoreless streak for a team, they start scoring again. But now it's up to Dock City to try and shift the momentum back their way here. So Kid Block's actually going to go back as a fifth blocker, going to set up and catch Bowden.
It's dangerous territory, but Kid Block, as we know, a very strong blocker, having blocked for a large majority of her derby career.
And especially at top levels, so like World Cup levels, blocking for England, one of the England's best blockers, certainly for a few years, and then made the switch back to Tiger Bay and to jamming. And as we said earlier, it's having that dual brain, if you know what I mean.
Yeah.
You know what the blockers are thinking, you know how a blocker works, but you've got the agility and the speed and the power of a top jammer as well.
Yep, and coming up against the jammer is, with those two brains, as you can see there, a good knockout to the outfield and the recycle back. Very solid work from Tiger Bay. So now just 20 points between the two teams, 6 minutes, 10 seconds remaining in this game. Can Dog Bay bring it back? Well, they're going to throw on Fraulein F. Reckless, who has been their highest scoring jammer, who picks up lead for Dock City. Chantel picking up a penalty, and that's going to put Chantel on 6 penalties now. So in a little bit of the dangerous territory for Chantel, one more penalty, we'll see her fouled out of the game. Recycled back on Fraulein F. Reckless. Goes round the outside, and that's Kemp going back in for a penalty as well. Good work there by Tiger Bay, just taking Fraulein F. Reckless to the outfield. But Fraulein takes the no pass, no penalty option, as Tiger Bay reset up at the back.
Tries to skip the inside apex of turn four, just knocks at the infield, has to be recycled back around. And we get a forearms penalty called on, I believe that's Pip Gray.
It is. In the meantime, Angie, who we've almost forgotten is jamming, because Angie's just gone into that blocker role with the star in hand, now is looking to try and fight back through. And the star pass has been given over to Chantel, who returned from the penalty box. So Tiger Bay are going to look to close this down as Fraulein F. Reckless comes through to try and get the points back in Dock City's favour. This is going to close the gap Tiger Bay have down to just 7 points.
4.5 minutes remaining in this bronze medal game. 157 players, 164. As we see Dos Santos just barreling Fraulein F. Reckless to the ground.
Tiger Bay fielding Kid Block. Pelvis Restley, however, the relief jammer from the first period for Dock City, has been fielded to try and sprinkle some magic on Dock City, but it's Kid Block who picks up lead for Tiger Bay. That is now Kid Block with a 2 out of 3 lead jammer. Oh, I see Kid Block leaving and returning round. Is that a recycle? Is that a penalty? And that is a forearm penalty to Kid Block. So we're on a power jam for Dock City's Pelvis Restley. Pelvis Restley at the back there with the star in hand. A high pass over to number 417, Tina Turner. Tina Turner's first appearance on this game as a jammer. Manages to push through to an out of play and is now around on a scoring pass. Almost taking up the entirety of the time, however, Kid Block has spent in the penalty box. And just being held now at the back of the Tiger Bay wall by Chantel.
This is also Dock City's first power jam of the period. They had three opportunities for power jams in the first period. Only a single opportunity in this one, and this is it now, or this was it. As obviously Kid Block's time's elapsed and is back on track in the back of that engagement zone, fighting against the Dock City three wall.
We have 20 seconds remaining in this jam. A knock to the infield and a pull back by Tiger Bay means that Tina Turner has to recycle all the way to the back on that long straight. A cut penalty issued to Kid Block. So that's a double power jam now for Dock City. But the time for this jam has elapsed just as Kid Block sat down. So that's going to be a power start and a full 30 seconds for Dock City.
It isn't, because we're going to get a jammer switch, as we've got Tina Turner, looks like, picked up a cut track at the end of the jam. So we're going to have Kid Block starting from the penalty box with... Ah, no, because Kid Block didn't sit down until the jam had finished.
So they are both going to be done. They are both done. Jam has started and they are both done.
The penalty box timer, just try to tell them both, you're done, go, you're done,
and they were like,
go.
Are you sure? I don't think they heard the jam start whistle. It was very quick whilst the discussions were happening. Kid Block up at the front. Chantel offering offensive help, but then comes back to try and bolster this wall, which is needed as Thrill Collins goes to the penalty box. And we are back to a very similar jam to the first jam of the game, with slow motion walls.
And there's only 7 points in this, with 1 minute of period clock, 1 minute 16 of jam clock remaining.
Offensive play coming in from Patty from the block, but Tiger Bay very much aware, and a star pass over to Thrill Collins straight away. Dock City look to do the star pass, but remember that lead has not yet been awarded, so they changed their mind. However, Tiger Bay now in a scoring position.
Dock City, you've got about 30 seconds to get out, get lead, call the jam and get a timeout made. That's the only way they can get this game now. 45 seconds left in the jam, 27 seconds left in the period, and 7 point difference now with Tiger Bay on a scoring pass.
So Tiger Bay are really just going to want a lockdown and not allow lead to occur at all. As they extend their own points lead over Dock City, we are down to the final seconds of the period clock. 5 more seconds for Dock City to break out. That is the period clock over. Jam clock has only got 12 seconds remaining. This is just going to run to the end now. Chantel picks up another set of points for Tiger Bay. And that clock is running down as Ollion takes the star pass for Dock City, but it is all in vain, as Ollion cannot get out in time. Time has run out on both accounts, and the game ends here.
Scores end. Dock City 161, Tiger Bay 178. Your unofficial score. Tiger Bay putting 10 points on the board in that final jam. That's the score made final now. 161 Dock City Rollers against 178 the Tiger Bay Brawlers. What a game and what a last few jams.
Yeah, it was from about 10 minutes into that second half. What happened to Tiger Bay, I don't know, whether somebody said something to them or whether they just really got into themselves and bucked themselves up, but that pendulum swung back across, and with just an occasional jam from Dock City in control, Tiger Bay had control of the last 20 minutes of this game and really just pushed their way through, picking up lead, picking up points, probably picking up a few penalties as well, but still being able to control. And it's the hold, that control they've had in those last 20 minutes that has seen them storm back up, catch back up to Dock City and take the lead.
So Tiger Bay did still have the lion's share of the penalties going in that second period. However, we saw Dock City almost catch up with about an extra 12 penalties put in their total. And again, we saw two power jams each there. There was that odd one, which power jam wasn't really a power jam. Jam of penalties, you know, that second last jam with the two jammers starting in the box at the same time. However, I think the Tiger Bay managed to put the lid on their penalties, and as we saw, Dock City switched over and they started having the blocker trouble and having the reduced pack sizes, which is never going to help you when you're trying to get out. And that was the issue that I think they had, where in the first period, even though Dock City were getting out and getting lead, Tiger Bay were able to get out and they were able to put the pressure on Dock City to call the jam, and we didn't see many big passes made. However, Tiger Bay here had the opportunity 7 or 8 times. I think that is a streak of about 7 jams where they had lead and they took control, put big points up and held Dock City scoreless, and I think that's what's really made the difference in this game. And it comes down to which team can hold their nerve at that point when you're constantly losing lead, you're constantly dropping points. Can you, on the bench, when you're seeing this happen, can you pick yourself up and come back out fighting? I think for Dock City, that extended period of inactivity for them was just too much.
Yeah, and it definitely was. Just Tiger Bay, that control, getting that lead, just holding that game. We're going to take it over to an interview now. We're going to pass you over to Brom, who's going to be interviewing skaters from that game. So we'll join you back here later on.
And so welcome to Trackside. I am Brom, and I am joined by Fräulein Freckles from Dock City, our fourth place team here at the 2018 Wftda International Continental Cup. How was that for you coming onto the track with Tiger Bay? You were the highest seed, and Tiger Bay have upset the bracket.
Yeah, I know. It's kind of with all our games this weekend, they were so tight. So we didn't know what to expect. I don't know. I think it's a curse we have right now that like every game comes down to the last second. So we couldn't prepare for that. But I think it was a really fun game. We have never played them before. And the two previous games, it was opponents that we know that we have played before. So it was, yeah, they are really good. It was an amazing game.
And so with the kind of it being so close throughout the whole game, how was the atmosphere on the bench, you know, throughout the entire game?
Yeah, we talked about that before the game, that yes, we're here, we played three games on a really tight schedule, and we are not we have been to tournaments, but we have not played like that since May. And people are going to get tired, and people want to give up. But then we have practiced all these hours, and we have almost... We are the team that comes the farthest from here, also Calio. So we really can't give up. I think that was the feeling.
And so we have quite a lot of new fans, or hopefully new fans, joining us on BBC Sport this afternoon. Could you tell me a little bit, just briefly, what drew you to roller derby in the first place?
I used to play bandy. Do you know that sport? No. It's like ice hockey, but without, you can't make hits.
Yeah.
It's on ice skates, and you have a ball. And I couldn't really, do the ball thing. And I also just wanted to go hit people, which I couldn't do. And then a friend of mine told me about this new sport. It had just started in Gothenburg. It was eight years ago, I think. So I got there and tried. And we didn't really know what we were doing, but it has grown. And I mean, it's really cool to be in a small sport like this and be there from the beginning, because then you can play these types of tournaments. I couldn't do that if I started soccer when I'm 26. So, yeah.
Well, thank you so much. You were the top point scorer for Dock City as well, for the top jammer. So thank you so much for joining us. That is our fourth place team. And I believe now we're going to bring in one of the Tiger Bay players. So I'm going to say thank you very much. I'm going to let you rejoin your team. And... welcome you. Oh, look at that. Just over to the shoulder. We're just seeing a hug between Tiger Bay and Dock City Rollers. And then coming in, we have another amazing derby story, because you have got an amazing derby story. Well, firstly, congratulations. The bronze medal winners here at the...
Match our uniforms.
Yeah, it will. Yeah, bronze will be a beautiful colour. Firstly, before we just talk briefly about the game, Tiger Bay aren't your first team. Tell me about your roller derby journey.
So I started off in Manchester, so I started off at a little team called Arcadia, and then shortly after I sort of passed my minimum skills, I moved to Rainy City, so that's where I spent about a year with, which was great. I loved it. It was while I was in Manchester studying and then working, and I really enjoyed it. And then I actually got a really bad head injury and ended up in hostel for 2 weeks, I think, which put me out of skating for a year. And then I sort of had a bit of a change in what I wanted to do with my career, so I moved to Sheffield for a new job, and skated with Sheffield Steel for a bit, who are lovely, and I love them to bits. And then I've moved down to Swansea to start studying medicine to be a doctor. So I started off with, moved down, tried out Swansea, but it wasn't quite the right fit for me, so I moved to Tiger Bay. So I've been with four teams.
So you've been with four teams. So you've seen a bit of UK derby at its finest over the years as well. And also you've progressed, you know, in a really quick amount of time as well. You mentioned minimum skills, which is the baseline skills test that all skaters have to play before they can hit the track and start playing like we've just seen. When was that? When did you take that minimum skills test?
I think it was, I started skating 5 years ago, so my minimum skills test was about 6 months after that, I think. And then I don't think I passed everything to start off with because the laps are really hard to pass because you have to be quite fit to do them. My housemate at the moment is just doing her minimum skills as well, so she's just about to pass, so I'm really pleased. But yeah, I think it probably took about, and I couldn't skate at all, so it took probably about 6 to 8 months to pass and be able to play.
And so now transferring that into this game where you're taking on Dock City, who were a formidable opponent. I mean, you've upset the bracket as well, coming in as the fourth seed and then now leaving as the bronze medal winners. What do you think that you, coming into this game, what did you think was going to have to be the rule of the day, kind of, and the approach of the team?
I think for Tiger Bay, a lot of what we try and do is try to stay really calm, because we can get a bit het up and we can get a bit emotional on the bench. So I think we've worked really hard on reducing penalties and making sure that everyone is in the right headspace, which is really, really good. A lot of that we've been doing a lot of sports psychology stuff at the moment, so that's really helpful, and a lot of team bonding stuff. And we're doing it for each other, and I think that's a really nice way to do it. It's a really nice way to make sure that, because if you're doing it for yourself, it doesn't work. It's a team sport, so we've got to make sure we're doing it for each other.
So what's next for Tiger Bay?
I don't know. I'd really like to play Dublin. I hope we do some more European roller derby. We're going to try and host a tournament next year. So we've got a bit of a funding thing going at the moment to try and host a European tournament. There's some information on our page at the moment, on our Facebook, Twitter, Instagram, probably everything. Help us raise some money, really.
And lastly, if someone sat at home right now, they've never seen roller derby before and they've gone, that's a bit of me, I want to be involved with that, whether it's officiating, announcing or playing, what would be your one piece of advice?
Well, it's really easy to find, first of all. So just Google your city plus roller derby and you'll come up with like any city. And don't be scared. Like, people are really nice. A lot of people feel like they're held back because they can't roller skate, and pretty much no one can roller skate when they start, so...
I couldn't.
You know? Brilliant. So don't be afraid if you can't skate. Lots of people ask if boys can do it, if men can do it. Yeah, of course you can. Like, there are men's teams everywhere. There are co-ed teams. There's reffing. There's all
junior
the crew.
Teams.
There's junior teams now as well, and they're adorable. Yeah.
Well, again, thank you so much for joining us here, Trackside. I'll let you get back to your team.